What's going on, fam? It's your boy Sydney and
in this video we want to talk about our first time having turkeys, raising turkeys, processing our own turkeys, and just some learning lessons for any of you that might be planning to do this and you might want to learn from our mistakes.
A lot of these things that we don't know much about, luckily we do have mentors. Now, we are first generation farmers. We started off as an urban backyard gardeners, and we went to a homestead, and that's when we became aware that we need to start growing our own food along with just, not just with vegetables, but now with meat. So this is our first time around growing our own meat, especially with turkeys. So if you going through this, if you have anything that we left out, comment down below and let us know. And if you're first time to this channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and hit that bell icon so you don't miss an upload.
After growing our own food and going to a homestead, it seemed like a natural next step process for us. I mean, we were producing our own food. We were preserving some of it. We didn't grow enough to preserve a lot of it, but we saw the next natural step would be, why wouldn't we have our own meat? Why wouldn't we have our own chickens, our own turkeys? Why wouldn't we be doing that?
And it's good because now that we've grown close to over 100 pounds of meat.
It was 200.
Was it 200?
200 pounds of
200 yeah. pounds of turkey meat that we know what it was eaten, how it was raised, and how it was all treated. And now we're going to be, well, next week, we're going to try it out for our own selves.
And we really tried to make the most educated mistakes possible.
So after we ordered the turkeys, we had them in the broody box. And Mrs. Nakid Gardner had to dip their beak into the water and get them the nourishments and things of that nature. The one thing I would like to change about that broody box was I would like to find a way to change out the litter a lot easier because the turkeys, once they get a certain age, I think it was what, week two, week three, we had to add extra bedding in there almost every 3 to 5 days.
They're messy. They're just really messy.
And it, that ammonia smell was just bad. That's one thing I would like to change on that. I got to figure out a way to do that. What about you?
You know, we have to really look at the design of the brooder box. We're going to keep the brooder box we have. Yeah. We love the brooder box that we have.
Just got to make some modifications
too. Yeah, we modified it to where we could have like the chickens on one side and the turkeys on one side, which is something I love that we did.
Yeah.
We could have ducks. We could have two different types of things. But we need to raise that divider because they started jumping over. As a matter of fact, I did a video of trying to solve that issue because they were like jumping over on each side. But we have to look at the design that we have and figure out a way to modify the floor of it, to do some type of trays for easy cleanup.
When we first got these turkeys, we were kind of hesitant because we've had a lot of people, especially our mentors, talk about how turkeys find a way to kill themselves. So at first I was gonna start with 10, but after hearing that, we wind up going with 20. And during the fact that we couldn't get our fence at a certain time, we was making sure we have our fence before we ordered it. So that way, when we had them in the brooder box, that they will be able to go out onto the fence.
We knew that there was a time frame.
Like, yeah.
We knew that there was a limited amount of time that we could have them in our brooder box. We were very careful about like when we were gonna order them and get our fencing because there's like 21 days or more. Like 21 days is the soonest that you can put them out, is what I've heard. A lot of people keep them longer, like 6 weeks.
Yeah, 4 to 6 weeks.
I can't imagine keeping them in the brooder that long.
Yeah, and we wanted to make sure we have all our infrastructures before we have any type of animals because we don't want to be scrounging up and trying to find out. But now that we finally got our fence and was trying to order it from Murray McMurray, they was all sold out. So we luckily Tractor Supply had some, but they didn't have any heritage breeds. They had the
We had the bronze-breasted turkeys.
Yeah.
Which we learned more about after having them, and I don't think I want them again.
No. So the next one we do get will be a heritage breed, because the bronze-breasted, they were hungry feeders. I mean, they fed. They were always seemed to be hungry.
They were empty pits.
Yeah.
Like, and they were. They got very aggressive at the end about food, like in general.
Yeah. So after that, putting them onto the grass and we're going to the Homestead and Life Conference, we started to get into late about the fermented feed, which kind of helps with the cost of our feeding both the turkeys and the chickens.
Well, part of that is that we didn't start off with fermented feed. And the truth is I didn't know a lot about fermented feed, and I didn't know how to change it from how we were feeding them to the fermented feed, and I felt very intimidated by it. And I'm glad that, like, you actually did it while I was gone a weekend, mm-hmm. and I came back, and he just was like, this is what you do. And I was
yeah.
like...
Yeah, and it was real easy. I mean, all you do is just mix your feed up with some water, stir it up every day for no more than 3 days. You could do it less than that, but it was just a good way to kind of decrease the cost of our feed.
We noticed immediately, because just prior to that, we found a way to cut our feed in half with where we found to buy it.
Our renters told us to go to a feed mill to get that, which even half that cost. And then once we started fermenting, they even half that cost. So, I mean, you can save a lot of money just by fermenting your own feed.
So that is something that I, in retrospect, that I know we'll be better about.
After it was time for graduation day to get them onto the grass, Mrs. Nakid Gardner had to figure out a way to get the fence laid out. I kind of got on her because I thought, why do you have it in this weird shape? But after myself putting it out on when it's time to move them, I found out it was the way they have it designed was weird.
How I was like really mad at you too. I was really mad.
What else is new?
He made me feel like I was just not doing anything right. And so I felt so good when you had a hard time with it.
Anyway, so after we was able to first get them out on the pasture, we had the turkey shawl, which they loved. They was kind of timid at first, but after the adult stage, they was able to get up on there and they actually loved it.
And when it started to get pretty hot, I got in trouble with him. I'm not sorry. I got a shade cloth thing and draped it over the top and made like this cover for them. And they like really loved laying up underneath that shade on the sides when they were not on the turkey shawl.
I like how you have it modified now, because now I didn't have to worry about cleaning off the poop off the shade cloth, repinning it, and things of that nature. I did buy like a little tent. It was like a beach tent, shade tent or something like that, where they kind of helps them out. We face it to the east, so when the sun sets, they'll have more shade and whatnot. But other than that, the turkey shawl, I'm glad that she did modify and put the shade, or actually not really a shade cloth. It was the landscape now that you have for the chicken.
Yeah, it's landscape cloth, but it acts as shade cloth.
Yeah.
And now that the turkeys have been processed, the chickens are loving it.
Yeah. A good thing while the turkeys was in the broody box is we started doing a call to let them realize it was time for a snack or treat for them, which eventually led out to a bucket training once they was into their pen. So about the end of the day, we'll do a bucket training, kind of get them used to the scene. That bucket is time to follow me. That way, if any of them got out, which sometimes they did get out.
Even before we put them out on grass, they were getting big enough that when I would open up the brooder box, they were jumping off the side, and like one or two like actually jumped out. And it was at that point that I didn't realize that they just wanted to come back. They didn't really want to run away. That was one of my biggest fears. It's that they were going to jump out and run across the street and get hit by something.
Yeah, but doing that bucket training definitely helped out.
A problem we started to run into with our bucket training is we didn't have a way to contain the birds other than them being on a bucket training walk. And those walks didn't last as long as it took to actually put the fence up. So to solve that issue, and it really saved us some headaches, we got an extra fence.
And this extra fence was allowing us to go ahead and set them up, set up the fence, do a bucket train walk out in the pasture where we just let them free range and pasture, just eat all the bugs, and kind of helped out around the August time frame when the army worms were just covered and just basically terrorized our field. And they were just picking them off. If they ever venture out too far, we'll just do our bucket train call and they're coming running back to us. But it was basically a time saver. Knowing what we know now, we realized that the broad-breasted turkeys is not a bird that we would like to be raising for being self-sustainable. With that being our last option, we had to go with that. We are going to get a heritage breed, and we're not going to get as many as we did previously. I feel that we have the kind of a system where...
I will say the broad-breasted turkey for us mm-hmm. was the perfect one to learn with,
yeah.
like our training wheels. And it wasn't until we had them that I even learned that they're just not a good bird to have if you plan on being self-sufficient and hatching out your own, breeding your own, because the objective is to be self-sufficient. And I don't want to have to be buying a bird from a hatchery every year. That's not self-sufficient.
Yeah. So we will be getting a heritage breed. Now, they do grow a lot slower than a meat type of like a bird, like the broad-breasted. However, we're going to just get them earlier. Not as many, because turkeys tear up a lot of pasture in just a short period of time. We started off with 20. Two died. Mysteriously, and then two that we had to cull ourselves because of their leg issue. Because, like I said, they grow so fast, so big. Sometimes their legs, that if they gather after some food, if there's a runt, they'll just mess up that leg or something.
Yeah, two of them were suffering the quality of life. I couldn't watch them live that way, so I actually culled them.
Yeah,
and you know, moving forward, I want to put in place a
weight system. So because we want to. After harvesting and processing these turkeys, I was surprised how small they were. Most of them range anywhere from 12 to 14 pounds.
Yeah.
The smallest one that we had was 9 pounds, around
and
nine something.
It was a runt, yeah. I would say that. And so I know you were really surprised about, because they looked a lot bigger, and even based on time frames to have them, it was the time frame to process them. We learned some lessons in that.
After processing them, we realized definitely 10 turkeys just for us two doing is probably the right amount. That we just got a system going, and we were able to get that through. We had a TikTok video that went viral. And one of our viewers, a few of our viewers.
A lot of viewers.
Yes.
With experience.
Yes.
Mentioned to us.
That we should have took the legs off and the head off prior to putting them into the plucker. We want to know from y'all, what do y'all suggest? We put them in after we do the scalding, or should after the scalding take their heads off and their feet off? Comment down below and let us know what's your process. So all in all, this was a great experience for us. It's a great feeling that we were able to raise our own meat, process our own meat, all by our own selves.
I'm proud of us.
Yeah, we did pretty good.
Yeah, we did.
Now we're ready for some meat chickens and some meat ducks.